most basic common link is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air.
When we talk about climate change or pollution, a lot of big numbers are thrown around, like how 33 billion tons of CO2 and 660 million tons of methane are released into the air each year. Is that a lot or not? To answer that question, we need to ask a question. Just how big is the atmosphere? Imagine for a second that the Earth is a soccer ball. How big do you think the ball would be if the Earth's atmosphere were added? An inch bigger, a centimeter? No, just over 1 millimeter bigger. That's right, all the air up there, all the molecules that keep everything alive down here would occupy the same amount of space as a few sheets of newspaper wrapped around this ball. And if we gathered up all the air in the atmosphere and put it next to Earth, it would look like this. At first glance, it seems pretty clear that there isn't that much air up there. So is JFK right? Do we actually breathe the same air that he, Marilyn Monroe, Charles Darwin, or Genghis Khan did? Smells like Einstein. I imagine the very moment that Einstein figured out his famous equation, he let out a sigh of relief. And that breath might have been one of the smartest breaths to have ever been breathed. Probability says that every so often when I breathe a little of that breath. To see just how much of that breath we all share, we'll use some round numbers to calculate about how many molecules of air there are in the atmosphere. The atmosphere is about 80% nitrogen and 20% oxygen. And scientists have worked out that the entire atmosphere weighs about 5 times 10 to the 21st grams. One mole, or 6 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of air, weighs about 28.8 grams. Which tells us that the entire atmosphere has about 1 times 10 to the 44th molecules in it. Take a deep breath. Now breathe out. That was probably about a liter of air, which at room temperature is about 2.4 times 10 to the 22nd molecules. To get an idea of how many molecules that is, if each of those molecules were a grain of sand, then you'd be dead because your lungs would be full of sand. And the entire United States would be covered in sand 8 stories thick just from the number of molecules in one breath. It also means there's enough molecules in one breath, so as long as the wind keeps blowing the atmosphere around, we've all probably breathed in one of Einstein's E equals mc squared molecules by now. At least according to probability. Given enough time, we will all share some small part of a breath. So JFK was right, we've all shared the same air. By applying a little science, we become acutely aware that our atmosphere, though seemingly enormous, is perilously thin and belongs to us all. Just as we've shared the air with great minds of the past, we'll share it with those who come after us as well. Let's take a little time to consider what we're filling it with.
Hello, I'm Charles Darwin, reminding you to subscribe to It's Okay to Be Smart. And share with your friends, because sharing is a highly evolved behavior.